about getting out and learning what the outdoors is.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to the Shooting Channel with me, Alex Sayer. So, first bit of news, Squig8683, you have not claimed your free gun yet. Now, all you've got to do is get in touch with us. You need to ring the Oxford Gun Company or comment below so that we can arrange for you to collect your gun. There are no catches. It is free and it is yours. Now, I've got some very surprising news for you this week, even more surprising than that. Beretta have bought Holland and Holland. True fact. As many of you know, Beretta started as far back as 1526. That's when Henry VIII was on the throne, just to give you a bit of context there. And Holland and Holland started in 1835. Gunmakers for the royal family, indeed. And I wonder how many of you viewers have got one or used one. This adds to Beretta's holdings and takes them up to 37 companies, including Benelli, who I'm sure you've heard of. Quite interesting is that Beretta's 92FS pistol is the official sidearm of the American Army. So the question is, will they start producing more parts in England, or will they start producing Holland and Holland parts in Italy? Let's hope not, eh? Moving on to Scotland, their country sports tourist industry has been denied coronavirus funding again. Well, Basque are on to this with an open letter which includes polite proposals for improvement. And our thoughts are with the Scottish field sports industry at this time. In Wales, Wild Justice have been forced to pay the maximum amount of legal costs for their pointless attack on Natural Resources Wales. And to complete news of the Union, Ireland is facing a ban on hunting with dogs. This is a private member's bill, and if you'd like to show some solidarity against the proposal, then I'll include a link in the description. And Chairman of the International Clay Target Shooting Council, Eric Conway, wrote us this letter from Dublin to reassure us of a bright and exciting future. As you may have heard, Ireland has recently been invaded by Europe, who have now withdrawn presence along the border. Vaccine supplies are believed to be at the heart of this, with the UK having invested and ordered somewhat more than the European Union. And this was, of course, made possible by us leaving it. The United Kingdom owns 75% of Europe's moorland, which is indeed rarer than rainforests, and we spend £52.5 million a year maintaining these beautiful landscapes, most often for grouse shooting. Beautiful though these landscapes are, my goodness, are they contentious. And despite the endless narrative of Wild Justice, I can confirm that on over 50% of grouse moors, hen harriers have been found alive, well, and indeed breeding. We need to burn little bits just to break up the fuel load. So if somebody does throw out a cigarette or has a disposable barbecue, the whole moorland doesn't go up in flames. So the government now seem to have got the hang of this and are supporting controlled burning on moorlands. Simple, but like most things rural and shooting, you do need that bit of understanding. Patagonia, the brand, seem to be missing that. You can follow me on Twitter, Alex@TSCNews, by all means. They started a website, Moorland Monitors. I had a look and cannot believe what I saw. Literally accusing gamekeepers of killing owls and their eggs. I'll never support the brand Patagonia, and I just wanted to let you know what was going on behind the scenes. I also noticed that they were talking about suing the president and taxing themselves a noble and globe-saving 1%. Meanwhile, back in the real world, the CPSA have confirmed that they are in touch with the Department of Culture, Media and Sport and are working hard for us to be out there. And we should, like before, as an outdoor sport and exercise, be among the first to see restrictions dissolve. And here are our Olympic and Paralympic teams heading to Tokyo. Here's the lineup look, and this is the first time that we've ever seen the Olympics and Paralympics combined. That's brilliant. Exciting times and lots for us all to look forward to. Thank you to everyone for watching. Please do share this news with your friends. Let them come and join us on a Tuesday night, Tuesday's news day, 7:30, like and subscribe, find me here, and Squig8683, please do get in touch, otherwise we'll have to do a redraw for all you lovely viewers and all those nice comments. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week, everyone. Bye.
Please share to your friends and have a look at what other films we've done. And it's all there to try and encourage you to get into shooting this great sport.